about me sound real good, but doesn't fit the life I lead. But let me tell you something, there's nothing new under the sun, and I don't care what you've done.
I love myself so I can be the best and optimal version of myself for God, that I might serve him through serving people. I set boundaries. I set boundaries in my life that help me to live healthy and peaceful life. Anything that disturbs my peace, that endangers my health, I put boundaries in place. That's people, that's activities, that's all of it. Jesus was a master at setting boundaries. We don't read that. We don't preach that a lot. But Jesus was a master at setting boundaries. Multitudes of people followed him. When the Bible numbered disciples while he was walking the earth, it numbered 82. He had 12. He had 70 others. The 12 were his apostles. The 70 others, they were disciples. He empowered them to do work. But guess what? The 12 were in one location. Then he had Peter, James, and John. They were in another location. You see, Jesus knew how to set boundaries to protect his peace. He knew how to set boundaries to live a healthy and peaceful life. He knew it. He knew it. In John chapter 2, when you get a chance, you can go back there. John chapter 2, Bible says, and when they saw his miracles, they wanted to make him king. But he would not allow them to do so because he had no need that anyone would testify of him. And he knew what was in people. And Jesus would not allow the wrong people to get into the wrong spaces. Well, what about Judas? Well, again, Judas was ordained. Psalm, it says that it was prophesied that he would do what he did. But even at that, Jesus was a master of creating boundaries. And when it was time for Judas to go, he created a boundary. Whatever you do, do quickly. Anything. Self-love means, watch this, because you are, again, his servant. You're his vessel. And he's told you not to cast your pearls among swine, not to give that which is holy unto God. Jesus has told you, giving you the permission to set, not just the permission, he's giving you the commandment to set boundaries in your life that help you to live healthy and peaceful. Like, beloved, John says in 3 John 2, beloved, I wish above all things that thou mayest prosper and be in health, even as your soul prospers. That's what he says. He says, I need you to prosper. I need you to be healthy. And the only way you can prosper and be in peace and be healthy is set boundaries to live a healthy and peaceful life. You set boundaries on yourself. We'll talk about this in a minute real quick. You set boundaries on yourself as it relates to what you put in your body. You set boundaries on yourself as to what you allow in your space. You set boundaries on your on your life as it relates to what you allow in your ears. You put boundaries on yourself as it relates to what you allow in your eye gates. You set boundaries. It's all about that. Self-love is about boundaries, 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 boundaries. And again, the enemy will take this and twist it and make you think that you're thinking it's all about you. No, I don't think it's all about me. It should be your testimony. It's all about God. And I can't allow anything in my space that endangers my mental, my emotional, my physical, my psychological, and my spiritual health. Because remember, I am set aside for his service.